There is a certain file in Windows that does not exist by default, but if you create it, will cause a permanent blue screen of death boot loop on your computer. This file is located in this System32 directory and is called OSData. But again, do not create this file. As you'll see, Windows is not even able to automatically repair it. So what is this file normally used for? And why does it cause a blue screen of death if you create it? I mean, obviously Windows booted just fine without it, so why doesn't it just ignore it? And is there any way to fix it? I'm gonna go over all that. First, let me demonstrate again what happens, and I'm gonna be using a virtual machine, obviously, don't do this. And basically, in this directory, which is gonna have all the different registry hives they're called for the Windows registry, if you create a file that has any data in it, or a folder even, called OSData, then after you reboot, Windows will immediately bsod and say bad system config info. Or if you created a folder instead of a file, it'll show a slightly different one that says config list failed. And no matter how many times you restart it, it will not fix it. It will try to do an automatic repair, but it will fail every time. Now, interestingly, if you create the OSData file with no data in it, it will not cause the blue screen of death, and Windows will actually fill it with about 8 kilobytes of data, and I'll go over what that is, but still do not create the file. I'll explain why in a second. Now, as for how I figured this out, I didn't discover it myself. I just saw it on Twitter. Someone posted about it. Anyway, I'm sure you're wondering more about what this OSData file is, and it turns out it's actually a registry hive, just like all the others that you may have seen if you open up the Windows registry. And for all of those files, if they do exist and are valid, Windows will load them into the different locations they're supposed to go. For example, the OSData one shows up under hklocalmachine OSData. And that's actually what happens if you create the empty file. It seems to see that it's there, but empty, and then I guess it initializes it and adds it into the registry. However, it still appears just empty, there's nothing in it. However, I strongly recommend against creating this file, even empty, because you won't be able to actually delete it again. When Windows loads the registry hives, you cannot delete them while Windows is running. You can't even copy them. So while it won't hurt to have the empty valid one existing, it still is going to be a useless file. More about what it's actually for, I did find a blog article or a wiki called Xbox One Research that shows that at least Xboxes, which do run Windows under the hood if you weren't aware of that, they apparently have this OSData registry hive and actually do have data in it. I also found another blog post from Google's Project Zero security team, and they posted an article about this and mentioned that OSData might have something to do with a Windows thing called state separation. And I don't fully understand it, but from what I've gathered, the OSData registry hive and stuff might have to do with creating different, basically system level configs. So for example, Xbox, even though it runs Windows under the hood, it probably runs a lot of different settings and different ways than a normal Windows desktop would, and I believe that's where those configurations go in the OSData thing. So on a normal Windows desktop, it doesn't have that, it's just kind of the default, but if it's a special version of Windows, maybe it does do that. And presumably what happens is if Windows sees that file and it's empty, then maybe it just realizes, oh, okay, I need to initialize this new registry hive. But if it does have data in it, it's not empty. Since that apparently is or can be a very important registry hive for like security stuff, and it sees that it's not empty, it probably just assumes that it's been corrupted. So if it can't read what's in it and it's there, I guess it's probably intentional that it blue screens instead of trying to load Windows in a compromised state potentially. They probably purposefully make it so Windows just won't even boot if the OSData stuff is not valid. Now, as for how one would fix this if it did happen to you, the original Twitter poster said that you can simply delete the file and that'll restore it. The problem is you can't boot into Windows, and even if you could somehow, you can't delete the registry while it's in use. However, you can delete it from within the Windows recovery environment, so I'll show you how to do that. This is just a good process to know in general, so I may as well share it. First of all, Windows will automatically enter the recovery environment after a few reboots that fail. So once it gets into there, you can simply go into the advanced options and then go to troubleshoot, advanced options again, and then command prompt. However, you'll notice that the prompt shows the current drive as X. That's not actually the boot disk that has all your stuff on it for Windows. It's kind of like a temporary one. So we need to figure out the actual drive letter assigned to the Windows installation, which is probably not even going to be C. So to do that, you would do disk part and then list volume. And then we can, in this case, look at the size to determine it, and we could see that the main partition basically is gonna be E drive. So we can switch to the E drive by just typing in E colon. You can't use the CD change directory command for entire drive letters. You just have to type the letter itself. But once we have that set, we can CD to that directory that we're dealing with. And using the dir command, we can see that yes, the OS data file is in there. So now that we know the exact full path, we can simply use the del command to delete the file like this. And now when we run the dir command again, that is not in the list of files in there. And now when we reboot Windows again, it works completely fine, just as it did before. So no, do not go pranking your friends by creating this file. I think it's kind of crazy that this is possible from a user space. I mean, you do have to escalate to admin to write there, but still. Anyway, let me know if you had heard of this before, and if you enjoyed the video, of course, you know what to do. Absolutely annihilate the like button. It really helps out. And if you want to keep watching, next up I'd recommend where I talked about the Windows exploit protection settings. If you've ever wondered how those work, I could put that link right there. And if you want to subscribe, I try to make videos about twice a week, so it should be worth it. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.